Kim, thank you. Commitment 2012 now. South Carolina's election season was marked by sharp words, lawsuits, and extra legwork. Candidates across the state were forced to collect signatures just to appear on the ballot. News 4's Myra Ruiz has more on these petition candidates. Myra.
Well, Nigel, political experts say those petition candidates were doomed from the start.
This election represents a kind of continuing trend of the last couple of decades.
Election 2012 was filled with memorable moments. No surprise, according to political experts.
Well, some people would say that South Carolina has more of a history than other states of having interesting races. Let's just put it that way.
More than 150 candidates across the state appeared as petition candidates on the ballot after an incumbent senator in Lexington County filed a lawsuit because his primary challenger did not electronically file some of her paperwork.
She is a executive, she says, in her literature with that company. And she don't know how to operate a computer.
It was a rule many candidates were not aware of. Consequently, many were forced off the ballot.
It's almost necessary to have an accountant and a lawyer on your staff to run for any office today.
Candidates were given a chance to collect a certain number of signatures in order to reappear on the ballot as petition candidates without a party affiliation.
It's extremely difficult for a petition candidate to, you know, to win an election. They got to convince people that even though they vote a straight party, to go to their office and vote for them specifically.
This year, elections officials say 50% of Greenville County voters cast a straight ticket ballot, a voting habit that Tommy Reese says possibly led to her defeat.
And the whole mess from the primary was just crazy. The cost, the expense, the time, the energy that it took to do the petition, although I'm thrilled that we did it.
Republican Senator Larry Martin won his race against a Republican petition candidate. While the system worked in Martin's favor, he says he will push for change.
But I'm going to work with the parties, Democrat and Republican parties, to ensure that we put the right bill together, so that we can address this thing in a way that this doesn't ever happen again.
In an ironic twist, the incumbent who started the petition mess lost his race.
And it appears that we can say goodbye to good old boy politics.
Five out of the 36 state-level petition candidates won their race. Political experts say it is rare for petition candidates to win, and it's nearly impossible for write-in candidates to claim victory. Nigel?